this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's ask the question, should you get your friends and family to review your app? All right, so today here we are coming again from the flat during the pandemic, and things have kind of got a new sense of normal to them. Like, even though everything's closed, life is so much different than it was just 3 months ago. It's been going on so long that it just kind of feels like this is just the way things are now. As a software developer, it's surprising how little things have changed, right? Can't go to a restaurant, can't go to whatever, but you know, work still continues and everything. But I hope you guys are all doing well and keeping safe. Anyway, so today I want to answer a question that came in on the last several videos from Test. That's the name, Test. Come on, you could have gone on something better, right? Test. Every time I see Test, it reminds me of those cringeworthy times where you send off a mass email to your users or something with Test. Ooh, that's embarrassing. Anyway, enough about embarrassment. That's what we talked about yesterday. So Test says, "Hi Eric, I wanted to ask you as a beginner indie dev with no marketing budget if it's okay to ask my friends and family to play and review my Google Play game, or if that is against the policies and can get me banned." All right, Test, I don't think that, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. First of all, I would encourage you to read the Google Play policies because it's not that much. There's not that much to it. Sometimes they can be a bit vague, but no, this is totally fine. I don't see anything wrong with that, getting your friends and family to download and leave a review. Now, I do think there's probably something wrong just on an ethical point of view if you say, download and then just give me 5 stars, right? You want them to try it out and give you the feedback and all that kind of stuff. And then, you know, then they'll give you the reviews, and hopefully you'll get more reviews, so it'll balance out over the course of time anyway. If you only have like 5 reviews and it's all your friends, then, you know, people will start to, well, you'll have that 5-star rating, people will see it, they'll download it, and if they disagree, especially if they disagree, if they see all 5-star reviews, then they'll leave a review, right? It'll all balance out. And I don't see anything wrong with this. It's the same as if I went out and I posted flyers in the neighborhood and said, hey, download this application. And then when they do download the application, then I have the pop-up that says, hey, please leave a review, right? It's the goal is to try to get people in and use your application. It doesn't mean you have to spend marketing money on it. However, what is against the policies is incentivizing the reviews. Like, I've had several clients, well, first of all, it probably crosses all of our minds, like, okay, what if I unlock a feature if they leave a 5-star review, right? But that's against the terms and conditions, right? Then the reviews become worthless. Or paying for reviews. I mean, I'm pretty sure a lot of my competitors, I think a lot of people think a lot of their competitors are spending money on reviews, right? Because, you know, and you probably get contacted by the spammers, or by, you probably got some spam or something that says, hey, we'll give you, you know, 100 1-star review or 100 5-star reviews or something like that. And I've never gone down that route. I've been tempted, especially in the past when things were just not getting the traction, but I've never done it. I'm really glad about it because that would definitely, I mean, if you get caught, it'd be a suspension. And there's just something just wrong about it, right? You know, the reviews are the one thing that makes, I mean, reviews are great. Reviews are that gives you the feedback you need to actually do them. And as I talked about many times before, you should respond to the reviews when you start to get them in. But to get that first kickstart, yeah, I don't think there's anything wrong with, you know, I don't even think there's anything wrong with reviewing your own application, right? I think it's kind of like, I don't think it's against the policies, but maybe it's probably against your ethical standards. Like, if you're the kind of person who, if there's a competition and you have to vote for the best whatever and you never vote for yourself, right, because you're thinking, I really shouldn't vote for myself, then that's, you know, that there's that kind of thing going in your head. But no, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. And anybody out there, if you disagree with me, let me know. But I don't believe it's against the policies. And if it is, I mean, how would they know, right? You just can't incentivize it, right? You can't cheapen it by, you know, I guess if you got your friends to do it, say, give me a 5-star review, and then you say, and then I'll buy you a beer or something. I mean, who's going to even know about that? But I think you're going to be fine, Test. In fact, there was a time where I was not doing that to my own apps, right? I was not even getting, like I wasn't even reviewing them myself. I was not even giving myself that first 5-star review. You know, it is. And as a user, I always assume, like, if there's less than 5, reviews and they're all 5 stars. I just assume that's the developer's friends and family. But anyway, what do the rest of you guys think? It's the incentivization that, and I know I've had competitors do incentivize 5-star reviews before. I've seen it in their applications, but it's a dark, that's a dark path to go down. So anyway, let me know if you guys disagree with me. Let me know if you guys review your own apps, because I've done that. I don't know if I've done it for all of them, but I've done it for quite a few of them. You might as well get that one review in there to get you kickstarted. And like I was talking about yesterday, that first review I've ever got was a 1-star, and then I tried to get my son to review it so that I could get it up a little bit, and he only went for 3. So it was like, anyway, I hope you guys are having a fantastic day. I hope you're staying safe, and I'll talk to you again next time.